Hello, welcome to my talk on the most useful Bernoulli's equation for practical internal flows. This is the first part of the talk on the topic, with the inclusion of the losses of the flow energy or energy head due to the fluid friction and the local changes. Such a modification allows a better estimation for the practical internal flows. The Bernoulli's equation for general inviscid flow is given as this. Here, V is the fluid velocity, P is the fluid pressure, Z is the coordinate in the vertical direction, see this coordinate. Rho is the fluid density. Here it is constant. G is the gravitational acceleration. And EV is the integral constant for the Bernoulli's equation. But it is actually the total mechanical energy of fluid per unit volume. So here I use EV for this total energy. In deriving the Bernoulli's equation, the assumptions have been made for the flow. For instance, the flow is assumed to be steady. Pipe flow, open channel flows, and many external flows can be steady. And the flow is assumed to be inviscid. For the most used, air and water can be taken as inviscid flow in many practical applications. The flow is incompressible when the flow speed is small, such as the flow speed in pipe, open channel, and external flows. Then the flow can be considered as incompressible. The body force is conservative. In most applications, the fluid gravitational force is the only body force. It is conservative. Along the streamline in the pipes, the whole flow can be taken as a steam tube. If we look at each section of the pipe, the parameters would not change very much on the sections. Therefore, we can take the whole pipe flow as a steam tube. Here, a special form for Bernoulli's equation is given as this, which simply divides the conventional Bernoulli's equation by rho g. Here, the first term is called the velocity head, and the second term is the pressure head. The third term is the elevation or potential head, and the term on the right-hand side is the total head, H0. Such a form of the Bernoulli's equation can be understood as the sum of the velocity, pressure, and the potential heads along a streamline is constant in the steady, inviscid, and incompressible flows. That means H0 is a constant in the ideal flow. Here, we can define the two lines. The first one is called energy grade line, EGL, so defined as this, and it is equaling to H0. Therefore, it is horizontal, the red line here. And the hydraulic grade line, HGL, given by the pressure head and the potential head. So it changes depends on the velocity in the pipe. And from this drawing, we can see clearly the component of the velocity head between the energy grade line and the hydraulic grade line, and the pressure head from the center of the pipe to the hydraulic grade line. The elevation Z is from the reference level to the center line of the pipe. But this reference level Z equaling 0 here, it's an arbitrary reference level. We can take anywhere, and in many cases we even take this reference level at the center of the pipe. Here we examine an example. The setup is very similar to the previous piping system, and we assume the velocity U1 equaling to U3 equaling to 3 meters per second, and U2 equaling to 10 meters per second, and the pressures P1, P3 are 100 kPa. Find the height H1 and H2 of the fountains see in this picture. At section 1 here and section 2 here, we apply the Bernoulli's equation as this. Here we already drop the elevation because this is a horizontal pipe. So based on this equation, we can calculate P2 as this, and use the long parameters, we can obtain the pressure P2 would be 54.5 kPa. And now we can apply the Bernoulli's equation for the point 1 here, the inner side of the opening in the large pipe, and the top of the fountain 0. So we have the Bernoulli's equation for the fountain height. Consider the velocity V0 at the top of the fountain. V0 would be 0. As well as the velocity at the opening, V1 equaling to 0, since the opening is vertical to the flow. So this is very similar to the hole for the pitcher tube. The hole is vertical to the flow direction. It only measures the pressure. And we notice here, U1 is the horizontal velocity, and V1 is the vertical velocity. They are different. Now we come back to the Bernoulli's equation, and V1 is 0, so this term would be 0, and this term is 0, as well as this one on the top of the fountain, pressure would be 0. And we also consider the position Z0 would be given by this equation. So put this together, we have the equation as this. Therefore, we can have H1 calculated by this, and we can obtain the result for H1, 10.2 meters. Similarly, we can calculate the height H2 given by this formula. So it is 5.56 meters. So we can see here, in this setup, it only depends on the pressure in the pipe and independent of the flow velocity in the pipe. So if we consider the flow is ideal, there is no friction loss in the small tubes and in the pipe. Thus, the fountains would have a pattern as seen in this plot. And we can see from here, regardless what is the speed in the pipe, the fountain height from the bent tubes here and here would be same as the energy grade line. In reality, due to the friction of the fluid, there will be loss on the straight pipes and on the local change of the pipes, such as the contraction and the expansion in here. So the overall head of the system would be reduced, and the fountains would not be in the same height as this. If this is not very accurate, then how we can solve the practical problem? For the real flow, we can apply the modified Bernoulli's equation for the internal flow given as in this equation. Here, HL is the head loss due to the fluid friction and the local change of the pipe system. And this head loss can be calculated based on the recommended method or the standards or even specified. Look at the pipe system here. If the flow is ideal and the energy level would be horizontal as seen in this horizontal line H0. However, due to the friction, the energy grade line would be reduced. So see here, at the end of this is different from H0. And at the construction, the loss of the energy can be seen in this red line. And in the small pipe, we also have small loss of the head given by this line. And the expansion of the pipe would cause a local loss of the head, so given by this line. And finally, we have the friction loss in the straight pipe here. So totally, we have the head loss HL here. And if we draw the hydraulic grade line, we can see something like this. Between the energy grade line and the hydraulic grade line, the velocity head for the straight pipe will be same here and here. If the diameter of the pipe is changed, so the velocity will be changed. So the velocity head will be large in the pipe of a smaller diameter. The difference between the center of the pipe and the hydraulic grade line is the pressure head. And the reference level and the center of the pipe is the elevation Z. Now, in the next two slides, we will examine how we can calculate the head loss. In the head loss calculation, the main loss might happen on the long straight pipe, called the major loss, which can be calculated using the formula given as this. Here, F is the friction factor, and the capital L is the length of the straight pipe, D is the diameter of the pipe, V is the average velocity of the flow. Generally, the friction factor can be calculated using the recommended equations or the method from the standard. Here, a recommended method, the Churchill equation, is given for reference. Here, the friction factor F is given by this formula. And this formula is for all Reynolds number for both nominal and turbulent flows, and or roughness. And the parameter A is given by this formula. Here we can see the roughness of the wall is included in the parameter. And B is given by this. Only the Reynolds number is considered. And the second loss is called the minor loss, or the local loss due to the valves, bends, the joints, inlets or exits, expansions, contractions, etc. The formula for the minor loss is given by this. Here, KL is the loss coefficient. So generally, the loss coefficient KL can be found in the reference books, such as the textbooks or the standards. For instance, from the reference here, we can see the inlet of the flow. If the inlet has the sharp edged angle, the loss coefficient KL would be 0.5. And if we have the corner rounded as this, and the loss coefficient would be reduced to 0.03 when the ratio of R over the diameter of the pipe is larger than 0.2. Another case is for an expansion of a pipe. So the expansion angle here is considered 20 degrees theta. And for the ratio of D over capital D at 0.2, the loss coefficient KL would be 0.3. And if we increase the ratio of D over the capital D from 0.4 to 0.6 to 0.8, and we can get the reduced loss coefficient 0.25 and 0.15 and 0.10. More information on loss coefficients can be found in the reference book. In this slide, the minor head loss would be calculated. So the case, it's an expansion of the water pipe from the diameter D equaling to 6 cm gradually to a pipe of diameter 10 cm, capital D. And the expansion section has the angle of 20 degrees. The average velocity and the pressure of the water before the expansion section are 10 meters per second and 100 kPa respectively. The question is to determine the head loss in the expansion section and the pressure in the large diameter pipe here. The solution, since D over capital D is 0.6, so we can look at the table here, KL would be 0.15. Then we can calculate the minor loss HL given by this, and we can calculate the minor loss as 0.765 meter. The second step, we apply the continuity equation given by this A1 times V1 equaling to A2 times V2. Thus, we can calculate V2 given at this, so we can obtain the velocity as 3.6 meters per second. In the third step, we apply the modified Bernoulli's equation given at this. Since the pipe is in horizontal position, thus the elevation Z1 and Z2 would cancel out each other. So we can obtain the pressure P2 given in this formula, and the answer for P2 would be 136 kPa.